So I want to talk today about the main spindle collet, the sub-spindle collet, and the guide bushing, and kind of what is the difference between them and what is the importance of each one. The collets, the main and sub-spindle collets, very similar. They're going to actually hold the material. They're going to clamp the material just like they would in a standard conventional lathe, just like your three-jaw chuck would. The collet system works a little bit differently on a Swiss-style machine. We use what they call a dead-length collet. So this surface is actually a flat surface, and when we push our sleeve, our collet sleeve, which is going to put the pressure on this, it's going to push forward. This distance never actually changes, so that's what they call it, a dead length. You're not drawing back and pulling back to onto the taper to actually clamp the material. You're pushing a sleeve over this taper, and that's what's going to grip that collet down. It's never going to move this distance. So same thing with the sub-spindle collet, is going to be a dead length collet. A lot of times the main spindle collet and the sub-spindle collet will be the same style collet even. It might be a TF37, a TF25, TF43, whatever type of machine you have, just different diameters. But a lot of times the main and sub-spindle collet will be the same style collet. So that's very similar. Each of them are gonna hold material and actually clamp down, and that's what's gonna hold it in place. Whereas the guide bushing, on the other hand, is a little bit different. The guide bushing never actually clamps the material. It's not supposed to clamp down like a collet is. The guide bushing is made to be a very slip fit around the material. So the guide bushing actually rotates synchronized with the main spindle. They spin together, same RPM all the time. So it's as though they're both stopped when that material slides in and out of that guide bushing. They're both synchronized, so it's just sliding straight through in and out. So all that's doing is creating a nice support right here around the material as you push it next to your turning tool. So it really reduces any kind of deflection in this direction, or if obviously this direction if you were cutting on this side. So all the guide bushing is doing is supporting the material as you cut. So the guide bushing typically, your collet is typically gonna be some kind of a steel material. You can get meonite collets, you can get carbide line collets if you needed to. You can also get some other linings and things like that to be more gentle on a ground diameter material. If you don't actually cut the OD of the material, you want a nice smooth finish. You don't want your collet marking up the material. So you can get different lands for a collet, but typically speaking, it's gonna be a steel collet, main or sub-spindle. Guide bushing, on the other hand, is typically the pads inside the guide bushing are gonna be a carbide pad. The inside of a guide bushing kind of looks like this. Or like this. So a little bit bigger in the back, cleared out, I should say. So what this area here, this surface area, is typically carbide. Carbide lasts a very long time, very wear resistant, very smooth. It can be ground to a very, very fine finish. So as that material is rubbing in and out of there, it's not actually gonna create any kind of drag marks or anything on your part. However, if you do run ground material, you can get different types of materials here as well. You can get meonite, you could get brass if you needed to, depending on what type of material you're running through it. Typically, these pads, if you order a standard guide bushing, are gonna be carbide pads. That's for longevity and for surface finish. You can get a really smooth finish. And typically, those pads, it's gonna be a steel frame around the collet, and it's gonna be a braze inside of here. The pads will be brazed inside the steel collet. So main and sub-spindle collet, typically the same, steel. It's gonna grip the actual material and hold it there. Whereas the guide bushing is more of a sliding surface. You're gonna be supporting your material as it slides through the guide bushing. So you don't wanna grip down on the material itself. It's not designed to do that actually. So that's just kind of a little bit of an explanation of what is the difference between a main or sub-spindle collet and a guide bushing, and what types of materials you can use.